Hey, people of the interwebs, it is Q, and this time we're not going on a scuba diving adventure, we're going on a kayak diving adventure. In this video, I'm going to show you what you need to go kayak diving, how you load your kayak up, and also how to get your gear off the kayak when you get to your dive spot, and how to get your gear back into the kayak after you've finished diving. Obviously, there are a couple of essential items you're going to need. The first thing is a kayak. I personally use a two-seater kayak. I sit in the back and paddle and steer and have my dive gear secured into the front seat section. The second most important thing you're going to need is a car with a roof rack so that you can transport your kayak from home to whichever dive site you're going to. You may also need the assistance of a friend to help you put the kayak onto the roof. But with my setup, I actually have my kayak slung from the rafters of my garage and a pulley system set up that I put together using an old boat trailer winch. So I can quite easily put the kayak onto the car and take it off again single-handedly. Obviously, once the kayak is on the roof rack, you need to secure it with some straps. I use a Rhino rack and it came with its own straps. And these straps I really like because the metal buckle is actually encased or surrounded by a very thick rubber. So when you're throwing the straps over the kayak from one side of the car to the other, the metal buckle is not going to bang into one of your car windows and potentially break it. These nice rubberized ones just bounce. Whatever you do, don't take any half measures. Make sure you put two straps on and make sure everything is neat and tidy and very firmly secured. Here you can see the metal buckle and the rubber that surrounds it. Make sure it's really firm. And these particular straps also come with this great little Velcro tie down, which you can use to secure the loose ends so they don't flap around in the wind when you're driving along. When you're happy the kayak is secured and you've got everything else loaded into the back of the car, you can quite happily drive off to your dive destination. If you're following the usual scuba diving rules, you will of course be diving with a buddy, so once you do get to the dive spot, you can help each other get the kayaks off the car and take them straight down to the waterline. It's much easier to carry an unladen kayak to the waterline than it is to load it up at the car and then try and struggle with all that weight getting it to the waterline. Attached to the side of the kayak, just to the right of the seat, you can see a black bag, and in there is my kayak anchor, which is also attached to a short length of chain, and then I've got 50 meters of rope in there as well. Next comes the fun part, which is getting all your gear from the back of the car and to the kayak and making sure everything is firmly secured into place. I have a set sequential way that I do this every time, and that way I'm never going to miss something. I start off with my flag, my paddle, and my integrated weight pouches. Normally when you go diving, you would have one of the divers carrying a dive flag which floats along with you on the surface, but when you are kayak diving, all you need is for each kayak to be equipped with a dive flag so that other watercraft can see there are divers down below, and if they know what the rules are, they have to stay at least 50 meters away from the dive flag. The golden rule of kayak diving is to make sure that every piece of equipment is firmly attached to the kayak, and I mean absolutely everything. You might think you're the bee's knees at kayaking, but once you've got all that dive gear and the extra weight in there, things really change if you've got some waves on the surface, and it's quite easy for one of these things to roll over. And if they do roll over and you haven't got something secured, you're going to lose it, and you don't want to lose expensive dive equipment. The straps I use are made out of a bungee type material, but mine are getting a little bit long in the tooth now and should be replaced shortly. I make sure that those are out of the way before I place my tank and BC and regs into the front seating area. And I always place my tank so that the valve is closest to me. Next, I pop my integrated weights into place. Now, if you don't use integrated weight pouches and you're still using a dive weight belt, then you would put that around your waist once you'd loaded all your gear, you were in your wetsuit, and you were ready to set off. So with the BCD and tank in place, we take our bungee cords and pass them through the D-rings on the BCD and then attach them firmly to the kayak. At this point, you can turn on your air because you're going to need to inflate your BCD so that it firmly locks it into place underneath the bungee cords. Next, I bring my mask and snorkel and fins, and I'm pretty lucky in the design of this kayak in that I have this handy little well that's just behind where I sit, and it's also got these buckles so I can securely fasten those things into place and they're not going to go anywhere. Obviously, things won't be the same with a different design kayak, and you'll have to improvise as best as you can. But the prime objective is to make sure that everything is firmly and safely tied down. Just before setting off, I always stow the paddle with one end underneath the BCD. A final check before we set off to make sure that we've got everything we need and everything is secured, because you don't want to be paddling out 50 or 100 or 200 meters and then get to the dive spot and find you've forgotten something. When you do reach your dive spot, the first thing is to drop anchor and make sure you get a good solid connection with something down below. Then stow your paddle and swing your legs over the side. Then I reach round behind the seat, and the first thing I want to do is put my mask on. Remembering, of course, that you will be out in the open ocean, so there will be waves to contend with, and the reason we put our mask and fins on first is because if we do happen to fall overboard or get knocked overboard, then we are able to see and also maneuver ourselves in the water. With those items equipped, it's a quick bum shuffle up to the front end of the kayak. And now you can see why I have the tank valve facing towards the seat, because if I need to switch the air on or off, I can quite easily reach it. Unhook the bungee cords from one of the anchor points on the kayak and pass them back through the D-rings on the BCD. Grab hold of the bungee cord that's attached to the kayak on the side that your legs are dangling over and secure the loose end to the D-ring on the BCD. This will act as a tether for when you throw the BCD and the tank overboard, because if there's any current on the surface, your BCD will be long gone by the time you've got yourself in the water and you're chasing after it. Always tether your BCD to the kayak, and always remember to fully inflate the BCD before you throw it overboard. Once the BCD is in the water, it's time to throw yourself in after it. Now it's time to cast your mind back to the hazy memory of your open water course, because if you were taught correctly, one of the things you should have learned was how to remove and replace your equipment on the surface. There are various methods of doing this, and it doesn't have to be textbook, it just has to be comfortable and easy. But what I do is open the buckle, open the cummerbund, make sure all the hoses are out of the way, and put one arm in first, followed by the second arm. With that done, do up the cummerbund, do up all your buckles, and tighten your shoulder straps. You may find it a little bit awkward or difficult at first, especially if there's some current on the surface or waves, but practice really does make perfect. Once you've got everything set up just right, it's time to untether from the kayak and drop below the surface. What we usually do is gather at the anchor line and head down as a group, because one of the things that you want to do when you hit the deck is to just ensure that your anchor is firmly attached at the bottom. You want that kayak to be exactly where you left it when you finish your dive. A really useful dive course to have if you are kayak diving is navigation, because you're going to use the anchor point as your fixed point and you're going to swim around and navigate back to that fixed point at the end of the dive. One of the other pieces of equipment that I'm going to be purchasing shortly for kayak diving is a very powerful strobe, which I'll attach to the anchor line around about 3 or 4 meters above the anchor. So assuming you've had a great dive and you've managed to navigate your way back to your kayak, once you hit the surface, it's pretty much a reverse procedure with a couple of little additions. Once you've fully inflated your BCD, the first thing to do is to tether yourself back to the kayak by attaching the bungee cord to the D-ring on your BCD. The second step is to get rid of that lead weight. Now, I use integrated weight pouches, so I pop those out individually and immediately put them inside the hull of the kayak. If you're using a weight belt, it's the same procedure. Immediately put it inside the hull of the kayak and secure that hatch. Now it's back to your open water training course where you remove your gear on the surface. And because your BCD is tethered to the kayak, you can quite happily just leave it be. When you're attempting to get yourself back into the kayak, I generally come from the opposite side to which the BCD and tank are tethered because it will act as a counterbalancing weight. However, in this video example, I can't do that. Launch yourself up onto your belly with your belly button around about the midsection of the kayak, and then just roll over and you'll be sitting in the right position. Now, as you remove each piece of gear, remember it has to be tethered. Don't leave it for a second, because if some freak wave comes and knocks you over or rolls the kayak, you're going to lose that expensive dive equipment. Again, I have a sequence that I follow, so the mask and snorkel comes off first, followed by my fins. At this point, you can quite happily leave your paddle floating on the surface of the water because it is tethered to the kayak and it gives you more room to maneuver. Another quick bum shuffle up to the front end and you're ready to bring your BC and tank back on board. Do up the cummerbund, make sure all your hoses are safely and securely inside, and do up the buckle. Now, because we removed our integrated weight pouches, there's a lot less weight that we have to drag on board. Again, it's all about practice and technique, and I use my foot to give myself some extra leverage to get the BC and tank on board. Once it's back into position, grab the other bungee cord and pass it through the D-ring of the BCD and securely attach it to the kayak. Again, fully inflate the BCD for the same reasons we did it the first time around. A final bum shuffle back into the seat, retrieve your anchor, grab your paddle, and head for home. If you found this video helpful and you'd like to see some more, please subscribe to the YouTube channel. If you have any comments or questions about this video or suggestions for other videos I could do, please leave them in the comments section. As soon as I see those, I'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and take it easy.